What do you think of gas prices?
It's getting very expensive.
What do you think of gas prices?
Like they're too high. Have been for 10 years.
Have gas prices affected you?
Oh yeah. I used to drive a big expensive car. Now I can't because it's too expensive.
Yeah, I mean they're high, but I live in Chicago over the summer, so I paid like $2.09 or $2.10 a gallon for gas, so this isn't so bad.
I live in Chicago.
Have gas prices affected you?
Yeah.
How?
Yeah, pay too much and you can't go as many places as you want to.
What do you think of gas prices?
I don't.
Why?
Because I get them paid for by work, I don't care.
Do you think that the way we travel, like using cars and etc., is going to change in the future?
Yeah, I think if the price is getting higher and higher, you know, people will probably have to choose another way of traveling.
Do you think that the way we travel is going to change in the future?
Yeah, I think they'll have like solar-powered cars, battery-powered cars, and stuff like that.
Have you seen any stories in the news about gas alternatives?
Yeah, I read them, but I don't think gas is way too efficient as an energy source, and it's nothing, you know. You know, you got to get your electricity from somewhere. Where are you going to get it from?
Do you think that the way we travel is going to change in the future?
No. Not. You know, back in the 50s, you used to see all those things about us riding around these levitating cars, you know, like in Star Wars. It's not going to happen. But as long as we have a cheap, fairly reasonably cheap source of gasoline, cars are going to be that'll be it.
How expensive would gas have to get before consumers change their habits?
It says here that in order for consumers to have changed their driving habits in the year 2000, the price of a barrel of oil would have had to more than double? I want to know more.
Well, the price of energy is still not very high.
We're finding that gasoline and diesel are actually a couple of the most efficient fuels on the planet today.
It's not all that high. It would take doubling that price to really force people and companies to conserve and develop other things.
Fuels like methanol or ethanol don't have the kind of energy density that gasoline or diesel have today. They require a lot more energy to actually produce them. And then when you combine that with the fact that they're not in very many places today, there's really no incentive for people to buy a lot of these fuels.
We have a system in place that distributes oil pretty efficiently and pretty economically, really, when you consider the rest of the world. So to go change that system is a pretty daunting task. It's a huge undertaking, maybe impossible.
Another reason that alt fuels really have not had a lot of success is because the infrastructure challenge is so huge. I mean, you've got close to, we figure, about $1 trillion invested in your current diesel and gasoline infrastructure that's out there. Customers can get the fuel anywhere, just about any time, and refuel their car within 5 minutes and have 400 or 500 miles of range.
$1 trillion is a large amount of money, but if we continue to rely on non-renewable resources, we risk, 1, increased economic stratification due to truly high gas prices and extremely limited availability. 2, comprising our national security increased dependence on foreign fuel suppliers. And 3, continued exploitation of the environment. If 10% of all the gasoline consumed in the United States had been replaced by alternative fuels from domestic sources, as stipulated by the Energy Policy Act of 1992, then $6.3 billion would have been pumped back into the economy. This is enough money to build 9 new Okemos high schools in every one of the 50 states per year.
Wow. Congress did try to reduce our nation's dependence on gasoline with the Energy Policy Act of 1992. This GAO report about the act that was written in the year 2000 says that Congress's mandate that federal agencies buy more alternatively fueled vehicles simply wasn't enough to achieve the goals set forth in the act. I wonder what we could have done in the year 2000 so that I wouldn't be stuck digging for oil.
you really need incentives. There's no economic incentive. These fuels are more costly, you know, it's more inconvenient. And time and time again, the survey has shown that nobody wants to mess with that.
We need to be as flexible as possible, make these things as broad in their application as possible, and it'll help them take root.
I think that it requires subsidies from the government because they're still very costly to produce, but they exist.
There's zero incentive for people to go to alternative fuel vehicles. That's why I think what we need is some tax policy or some incentives to encourage people to try alternative fuels, because in of itself, it's not going to happen.
You have to curtail consumption. The only way to do that is impose a tax on gasoline.
So to the extent that we slowly change that system and have areas that now offer alternative fuels, and somebody comes along and pays for the tankage and pays for the special pumps or pays for the natural gas refueling or the electric outlets or whatever is necessary for these things to flourish, then they'll take root. I think it's definitely a role for government. I think if government can step in and either through tax incentives or some other economic means help people make that transition, it'll happen that much sooner.
On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends. I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again. Going places that I've never been. Seeing things that I may never see again. I can't wait to get on the road again.